With the increasing population, the passenger flow pressure of urban rail transit is also increasing. Besides, some cities are not suitable for large-scale subway construction. Take Lebanon as an example, as the ancient capital of 13 dynasties. There are many ancient tombs under Lebanon. Building subways in other cities is exhausting at best. And build the subway in Lebanon. The Cultural Heritage Bureau has to monitor it. Take the second line for example, in the early exploration. There are 57 cultural relics on the north-south axis of Lebanon. From the kings of the Western Han Dynasty to the Ming Dynasty, the vassals of Zhou had them. I can take you through the history of ancient China. Since the ground cannot be moved, is there any other solution? Chinese engineers are testing another form of transportation. Air rail transit system. The air rail transit system is called Sky Rail for short. Belongs to the suspension monorail system. The track is above the train, supported by steel or cement columns in the air. This seemingly unconstrained design. It's not that the Chinese are crazy. It has been used in the West for more than 100 years. In 1901, the world's first Skyrail train has opened in Germany. German industry was flourishing. The population density is very high, so it brings great pressure to the ground rail transit. And the underground rock structure of Wuppertal, Germany, and abundant water resources limit subway construction. The engineer looked into the air, hence the curious monorail in the sky. Then why after 100 years of development? Why Skyrail is not popular all over the world? Because it's really hard to build. Before China, only Japan and Germany had space orbit technology. On November 3rd last year, at the International Bridge Production Expo held in China, it has unveiled the suspension monorail train developed by China Railway Engineering Group. It makes China the third country after Japan and Germany to master space orbit technology. The company is building a 1 km test line in Wuhan. A trial run is planned shortly. According to the person in charge, the Skyrail train has a top speed of 70 km per hour. The carriages are usually 3 to 5. The car design is very similar to that of the subway, but smaller and more refined. Each car is about 11 meters long and 2.4 meters wide. It can seat 80 to 90 passengers at the same time. The empty track carries one-third as much traffic as the subway. It can handle about 10,000 passengers per hour. It mainly serves the suburbs of large cities and the urban areas of small and medium-sized cities. Compared to the subway light rail, empty rail, although less passenger capacity, has several points. First, the construction cost of the empty rail is very low. An empty track of the same length costs only a third as much as a subway. Second, the space track is developing upward. Take advantage of the middle of the city's roads, flower beds and other places to build columns. It will not occupy another land in the city. The problem of traffic congestion has been greatly alleviated. In addition, the Skyrail has 3 times the climbing capacity of the subway. The turning radius is half that of the subway, applicable to all landforms, especially in mountainous areas like Chengdu and Guizhou. The same vehicle. So why are so few countries able to build space rail? Air rail is currently only in Germany. A few cities such as Japan have been applied in the field. China is just beginning its trial run. China has also built a monorail subway in Chengdu. But on the ground, hanging it in the air is another matter. First, monorail train and the aspect of track change. It's more complicated than the two-track train. A slight mistake may cause the train body to temporarily separate from the track. There is even a risk of derailment. This can be fatal to a suspended carriage. In addition, the train sits important as low as possible. Try to be as simple as possible in design and development. Keep only the necessary functions of the train. But be safe too. Third, when the train was forced to stop in an emergency, rescue work is difficult for passengers in the air. It's not as simple as smashing a car window to get out. At present, vertical and horizontal modes are adopted for air rail rescue. Longitudinal rescue is to send a trailer to pull the damaged car into the station and then evacuate passengers. Lateral rescue is on a two-way road. Send another empty rail to pull up next to the damaged car. The door is opposite to the rear, enabling the passenger to complete the change in the air. In more extreme cases, you might even consider using a rope drop. The most important train scheduling. We can imagine a train going 70 km an hour. What are the consequences of another derailment in a Mandair collision? It should take these safety issues into account. If it's safe, The combined advantages of empty rail far outweigh its disadvantages. And our country Sichuan, Shaanxi and so on many places. Both have put forward the idea of building an empty rail. Wait until Wuhan Air Rail Test Line is completed. The SkyRail project will slowly be rolled out in other cities as well. To contribute to the development of urban rail transit in China.